reminded me of holidays that we'd been on, and it was pretty cool to be able to go from Girona, which I associate with the heat, to getting up here in 120k. Already scratched it up so much.
It's got some character now. It's how bikepacking should be.
I just arrived yesterday. I don't know the plan, but I think we're gonna ride our bikes into the mountains.
I will just follow
follow Mike. He's the route planner, route maker, route
dictator.
Seeker,
route dictator,
route leader.
Where are we now? Which village?
El Flufia. I think it's the water. Where are we, Mike?
Bezalu, right?
Bezalu.
Bezalu?
Bezalu.
It's in the top 5 most beautiful villages in Spain. Oops.
We start here a little bit outside of Bezalu. A lot of people already know Girona, but we want to go into the mountains, find some new places and explore a little bit. We have a 3-day trip in mind, like close to Andorra. There's some crazy spots on the map that we think that would be cool if we go there. 130 kilometers a day today, only uphill almost, 1000 meters. Tomorrow we do some more exploring there, and then we take a route back, but we will see. We grab a lot of stuff with us, but I think we will see some snow.
Bye-bye. Stay still.
How far have we gone?
2 kilometers.
Leg warm is coming up already.
Yeah, I'm and coffee time already.
Problem is a little bit with the Rambion crew that we always start too easy, and then in the end it is always a rush for the last part. And the last part today is a lot of climbing, so we will see how that goes. But
we'll have to hold on to Rule's sea post.
Yeah.
I've got plenty of space to hold on to.
What are you most looking forward to?
Adventure in general, I think.
Not wearing your Crocs.
Ooh,
I'm looking forward
totally
to
about my Crocs, my new Crocs. No, but it's a fashion statement, but also it's pretty handy.
If it's a double L,
de la Roja.
That guy said in 100 years it would fall.
Yeah.
Yeah?
I think he spoke with
an old man.
With the old man. How old was he?
He was 87. He said...
You mean camera? He said that this place might fall down in 100 years because of the rock that is underneath. It's just not very stable to build a city on. But we are standing here and it feels pretty good. So...
Now you're making it worse.
I think he's talking rubbish.
Casa Folli, la Roja.
Yelmo, get that content.
How long is this climb?
14 kilometers. Oh, what? 13.8.
Thanks. You up for it?
What, you in a race?
No.
Good, because I'd lose.
I saw on the map like a super straight line, and all the roads here are super windy, twists and turns. So I thought, what is happening there? It was like an old train track there into the mines.
Okay.
And they make a cycling path now for children and for us. We act like children.
Yeah.
Hoppa!
So let me find where we are now. This is the red dot, and the red dot is
here.
Where? Here.
Hey!
Yo, yo, yo! Lovely view.
Yeah, beautiful. Feels like Austria.
Beautiful climb.
Beautiful but hard.
Pretty steep, hey?
I'm not made for that, but...
Yeah.
The steep part.
Yeah.
I think we just did...
Yeah, exactly. That.
Really helping out all the tourists here with the Catalan signs.
Del BAC San Pau de Segueries from the village of San Pau de Segueries as one of the main entrances to the Ain of Alta Garrotxa. In this place stands out the large mariner farmhouse, which according to legend was founded by a sailor who wanted to escape from the sea and find a place where no one had ever heard of it. Scattered throughout the valley, there are several interesting Romanesque hermitages, such as those of San Andreu de Porres, Santa Magdalena del Col, San Feliu del Bac, and Santa Maria de Lungariu, where the schools had been, and the hostel
Bac. Something in the valley, something about farmhouse, something about family. I can tell you one thing. I've been here before. I came here weirdly on a walking trip with my friend, like 5-6 years ago, and in that village is where we finished. Took us 4 days to literally do what we just rode. So I guess bikes are better than walking. And we're going a lot further this time into the mountains. Woo! That's not UCI legal, my friend.
Oi. Old man, standing up.
Okay, let's go.
Vamos.
In front of the train. What are we doing up here?
I think the train's starting to sound again.
What's going on here?
You can do it.
Crazy how like at the bottom of here felt like we were near the coast, and then you come up here and all of a sudden like there's ski shops. Everybody coming down the hill and the skis and snowboards on their cars.
And a different vibe directly. You don't feel like Spain. It feels directly like Austria or Switzerland or something.
Italy.
Wrong side! No! Don't leave me! Don't leave me! Get in the kilometers. Cool, huh?
Yeah.
It's like endless. You can hardly see it in the video.
Yeah, it's so cool that that side was still all green and then this side is just...
All white.
Those five glaciers on the other side of Andorra, they estimate now that in 50 years there will be no glaciers anymore here.
Nothing?
Nothing in the Pyrenees. We will see how it goes, but that's not a good sign, I think.
Managed to lose them.
I don't know where it is.
I think it keep going that way, maybe. Woo!
Skinny.
Wow. Yeah, it's okay. Here.
Look how cool.
Okay, boys and girl, what's happening today?
Morning.
Riding crossing
some borders. Gonna
ride 55 k's.
Sounds
in
good.
In an attempt to cross nine borders.
Right, Mike?
But it's Spain, though.
Yeah, it's Spain. Catalunya.
That city is France. Behind there, Spain again. We're gonna find some gravel roads. Go into more France, more of Spain. More of France, more of Spain. More France, more of Spain.
More France?
And then we're back.
Oh, all gravel border.
You gotta go on the gravel borders if you don't have your passport.
Okay, let's go.
Short ride. Crossing some borders, getting some coffee, getting some great lunch somewhere.
This is the border, I think.
Oh yeah? Where are you going up?
Your sketch.
Nice.
You feel the French Frenchiness.
You're illegal in France.
Feel like a smuggler.
Yeah. Never post a photo, I think, with power lines in it.
French don't like snow, they do everything warm.
Bonjour, bonjour. Le chien. Hey, chien, yeah.
Yeah, the chien.
Would you go?
Café con leche, le cuento, por favor.
Exactly the border.
I see why they put the border here.
Go that way. Alright, do that.
Sick.
You really learn that borders don't mean anything.
No, you can just cross it like nothing. Yeah, but it's important, right? That's the message.
Buenos dias. It's awesome.
Who cares?
Let's see, what's the story behind this little town? Livia? Livia. It is a Spanish exclave surrounded by the French department of Pyrenees. Cappuccino. So population, 1500 people. Elevation, pretty high. During the Visigothic period, its citadel, the Castrum Libiae, was held by the rebel Paul of Narbonne against King Wamba.
Wamba?
King Wamba. Oh, something about Abdulrahman al-Ghafqi. Rebel. The route National 20, so Vent. The road has been the subject of. No, it's just a lame story. It's a lame village. No. Cut.
This is the town that is in France, but is a Spanish town, right?
Yeah, but it was French. It was part of France in the 15th century. After the Catalan Civil War, and said that all cities, what was it? All cities are?
All villages.
All villages. Ah, but this is a town, so it's not part of the deal. So it remains part of Spain.
Livia.
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 I don't live here.
And that's a wrap.
You made a little funny joke.
Yelma, skids are for kids.
The bike. He wants to go. Oh, easy.
Steady on that.
Childish.
Getting hot. Hot.
Yeah, I think this was the palace of Caesar. This was his bedroom. Good panorama view window here.
Yeah.
And he could just watch all his army, where his army was living down in the village or the town.
This is 100% not facts.
Okay, we read on Facebook and Asterix and Obelix were living there.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Down there.
And then they walked this road, down this road, and then just killed some Romans there.
Yeah.
Like knocked them out of their shoes.
Yeah.
Yeah, happened. The highest top is La Carbasa. That's
yeah.
I see a lot of snow in that top.
Pow!
Yesterday we were there.
This one.
Not to to explain what's all happened.
I think there's just this whole place has just been back and forth with over the last centuries as to who owns it, whose land this is.
Somewhere in the Pyrenees, and it's always known by steep hills and steep mountains and everything. And this is so wide valley.
Should we head on down the hill on that road down there? Yeah. It looks like a lovely road.
We take the old road, the third one.
The old road or the alt road?
Old road.
Mostly downhill today.
The first bit is climbing, right?
Yeah.
So that will be the best part.
We're going up to 1,900 meters, so hence the gloves, leg warmers, jacket. It's pretty chilly.
Yeah. Here it still is, but Girona seems to be like 18 degrees. Yeah.
It's funny to see all the people going up, all the cars with the skis on.
Yeah. This is definitely my favorite point of this trip. It's like such a throwback to, I went on a couple of skiing trips when I was younger. And it's just like, I haven't been up in the mountains like this in a long time, so.
This is pretty cool.
Just crazy that, like, coming from Girona, I know it's, the weather's been bad in Girona recently, but like, coming from somewhere that I associate with so much, like, hot weather and going to the beach and stuff, to be able to ride up to this, it's just like, yeah, that's pretty cool. Pretty cool. It's not actually that far. I mean, we've done quite a lot of climbing, but very rideable for the majority of riders out there. So if you're looking for an adventure, this definitely ticks some of my boxes. Okay, into the snow.
We'll see.
Yeah.
It's getting colder and colder.
Jacket's got a life of its own.
Impressive.
Going to rob a bank.
Where did this bike go?
Hey.
I think I'm ready.
Almost there.
Very nice. say to the other guys, I like it so much. So one crazy other guy, but the rest, I have a feeling that we're the only crazy ones doing this instead of if you're sometimes riding in Italy in the mountains or somewhere else. With some like Neanderthal cyclist, you're feeling one of those. But now you're alone riding on this mountain. It's beautiful. Don't look even that steep. Just so nice and so.
Pure sugar, lovely.
Good balance between
sugar and sugar.
Sugar and sour.
Thank you.
Did you see who won the sprint at the top of the mountain?
Yeah, we saw
it. Highest mountain of the route. Same.
Little buck.
It's beautiful.
Quiet.
No people at all.
On the road again.
Sun is out, jackets are off.
Pizza's in the tummy.
Let's do the second part of the ride.
Yeah. Get there before it gets dark.
I hope so. Legs are coming out.
Town sign. Happy? Beautiful. First flat tire of the trip.
Do we need some drama?
Yeah, the first.
Huh?
Do we need some drama? Why now, Yasmin? I'm tired. I need to go. I want to go home.
First flat. I think we've done well. Maybe we take the road after this.
It's fun.
Travel lifestyle.
A nice, flowy.
Never had a flat before that.
No.
And you've had two in 1 week.
Yeah.
Go.
Shit happens.
All the way.
We were going as fast as we could.
Yeah.
About what, 70k an hour?
70k, and then?
And then I was on my top tube, UCI illegal.
Yeah.
And I came off my top tube.
And then?
And my Wahoo hit the DJI camera.
Yeah, and it tumbled like for 100 meters on the tarmac.
Yeah.
You broke the display.
Yeah.
But it didn't break the lens, so it's still working.
Yeah.
So that's a good thing.
Sorry,
after
my
that, it was a little bit like this.
Gravel.
Downhill.
Yeah.
40k to go, something like that. A little bit more than
hour and three quarters.
Three quarters. Yeah, with this tempo.
Who knows what can happen in the next 40k?
I'm prepared, so.
Yeah. Another puncher.
The same thing was my mistake. I know it won't solve my problem, but I know it makes a difference. One more sip and I'ma fix it. Out my body when I'm tipping. I told her one more, she hit me, say you quit or she dipping. Yeah. Let me do my thing. Got them greens and pinks and blues, I'll give my kids a change. Don't call me a sip for none unless you do the same. I wanna catch as fast as hell and I don't do no range. Yeah. All I ever wanted was to live.
Made it.
Yeah, I love the
made it.
How was it?
Surprisingly nice, I think. Yeah. I thought it was gonna be like a highway style all the way to the end, but we got some nice gravel parts.
Two flats.
Ooh.
Made by me.
Every time I give an action camera to someone else, this would happen.
I was in like aerotuck, and then I came up from aerotuck and it caught on my Wahoo like that and just fell out my mouth. never ridden a road bike on gravel before, and we've ridden quite a lot of gravel, especially yesterday. And it felt very natural on the Zalco, which was a bit of a surprise. I was expecting it to be much more rattly. Carbon bars, carbon seat posts, took some of the rattle out, which was nice.
I'm not that kind of a climb person, as I'm really tall for a girl, but at some point I was on my own, and it actually felt quite good because then I just could go on my own pace, and I started to enjoy all the mountains around and all the trees and just the silence, I guess.
I like the nice weather the most if you don't expect it. Last week when we did the last preparation for this trip, I thought we only got rain. I brought two rain jackets with me, bought new overshoes here in town, and then you're starting without leg warmers, and for me that's always the best for a ride if the weather is better than expected.